The iPad has been around for over a decade, but Apple still hasn't created a weather app for it. And in order to understand why that is, we have to consider Apple's overall product strategy. In their ideal world, Apple users would own a Mac, iPad, iPhone, and Apple Watch, with each product optimized for a slightly different user experience. If you're going to write a paper, edit a video, or watch a movie, using the Mac makes sense, since it offers a full-sized physical keyboard with a precise cursor and large display. But what if you just want to do some online shopping or play games while sitting on the couch? You'd likely reach for your iPad, since it's lightweight, offers touch controls, and has a good-sized display. But what if you want to quickly check your email or reply to texts? Your iPhone is the perfect device, since it's likely within arm's reach, ultra-portable, and quick to use. Finally, what if you just want to see what notifications you're getting or check the weather? The Apple Watch is the most efficient way of accomplishing those tasks, since it's a wearable device, always on your wrist with information just a glance away. So based on this product optimization hierarchy, Apple emphasizes certain tasks in certain areas. For example, there's no calculator app on the iPad, since you're more likely to use your iPhone or Apple Watch instead. And there's no Final Cut Pro app on the iPad or iPhone, since you're likely to have a better experience on a Mac. And Apple took this same approach with the weather app, believing there isn't a huge need for it on the iPad or even the Mac, since using your iPhone or Apple Watch would be quicker and easier. Now, that doesn't mean Apple will never make a weather app for iPad, it just means it hasn't been prioritized. In fact, we've seen this story before with Siri. At first, the voice assistant was only available on iPhone. A year later, they brought it to iPad, and 5 years later, it finally came to the Mac. And I expect we'll see the same type of trend with the weather and calculator apps on iPad. This is Greg with Apple Explained. Thanks for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.